Hey everyone, it's Dave. Thanks for watching as always. I hope you had a good long weekend, at least if you're Canadian or American. I'm not too sure if the New Zealanders, Europeans, and all the rest had a long weekend. Anyway, today what I wanted to do was take a look at all the updates we have around Rocket Lab's Neutron development and just give you guys some updates on how the Neutron development process is shaping up. Before we get into that, though, I hope you'll consider hitting like and subscribe by the end of the video. Every subscriber helps out so much with the channel. You're all very much appreciated. We actually just hit 3,000 subscribers. Pretty big milestone for me, at least. I know it's kind of peanuts compared to some other channels, but I was pretty excited by it. So if you're one of those 3,000, thank you so much. All right, so when it comes to Neutron development, the way I tend to think about it, of course, there's tons of different ways of breaking things down, and it really depends on how granular you want to get. But the big lift items that need to be completed in order to get a prototype on the launch pad are really, number one would be Archimedes engine development. Obviously, propulsion and engines are one of the most complicated, one of the most difficult tasks with any rocket. Archimedes is a brand new engine. Rocket Lab's working very hard on getting that up and running. Number two would be your upper stage tanks. There has to be a lot of testing around that in order to get the vehicle ready to go. We recently saw the Vulcan rocket actually have some failures around their upper stage tank, and they have to do some modifications to it, causing a lot of delays, so something you don't want to see for Rocket Lab's upper stage. We also have the first stage tanks, which is a lot of the main portion of the vehicle. We haven't seen as much progress on that. The main stage tanks, the holding all the propellant, oxidizers, all the rest. And then the fourth is not actually the rocket itself, but it's extremely important, something I've been trying to look into pretty closely lately, and that's actually the launch pad, landing pad, and all the infrastructure that goes with it. So the rocket is not the only thing needed in order to launch a rocket. There's a lot of ground infrastructure that needs to be in place. Obviously, there's going to need to eventually be a barge as well in order to catch those downrange landing launches, bring them back to the site. And really just wanted to check in where we are on that one as well. Because if we're hoping for a launch by the end of 2024, that's really not a lot of time to get all these things done. So let's dive into it. So the first thing I wanted to look into was actually number four on our list, and that was the launch infrastructure, mainly because it's easier to see what's going on there. You can check out satellite footage, all that kind of thing. And it's really impossible to hide, you know, ground being paved, landing pads being built, launch pads being built, that kind of thing. And really, if we're gonna have a launch by the end of next year, they do need to get going on this launch pad. If you think back to the new pad in Virginia for Electron, that was actually announced in October of 2018, and then construction was said to be completed for the pad in December of 2019, although the inaugural launch was much later due to a lot of these issues with NASA and the flight termination sequence and that kind of stuff, all this red tape. But basically, sounds like a little bit over a year to get the pad Electron launching at Wallops. So seeing as how we're, you know, a year and 4 months out from the end of 2024, it seems like they really need to get going on this launch pad, something I've been a little worried about and a lot of other fans have been worried about too. And we do have some news on it, so let's take a look at what's going on. Okay, so hopping on over to Main Street Data here, by the way, there is a referral link to that in the description down below, and they do include transcripts for all the companies they cover for all their earnings call. And what I really wanted to highlight here was the second quarter earnings call that happened a little while back. They did talk about Launch Complex 3 in Wallops. The quote here is that earthworks at Launch Complex 3 in Wallops, Virginia, have commenced, enabling pad construction to commence in Q3. So earthworks are like, you know, leveling the ground, getting everything ready to go for the pad construction. And Q3, which we are currently in, is when pad construction should commence. So once complete, Neutron should enjoy all the benefits that come with launching from a pad with clear line of sight to future launches that has significantly less congestion, all that kind of, you know, promo stuff. But basically, the info that we're most interested in here is that earthworks have supposed to have already commenced, and the construction on the pad should be starting this quarter. Now let's go ahead and zoom in to Wallops, Virginia in Google Earth and take a look at the lay of the land. Okay, here we are in Google Earth, Wallops Island, although call me crazy, looking at the video zooming in, it doesn't look like an island to me, more like a peninsula, but maybe I'm missing something. Anyway, Wallops Island launch pads, so Electron is launching from here, and in Google Earth, we're not actually seeing too much work going on, but it's not updated the most regularly. What it is though is extremely high resolution, which is kind of nice. So around here is where Electron does launch from. So not a lot to see here in terms of active construction going on. Just kind of take a look at the lay of the land here, and we're gonna hop over to Planet Labs, which lower resolution but updated daily, which is the great thing about Planet Labs. You can see the changes as they're happening. So here we are in Planet Labs, same location. You can see the very distinctive curve of this river here, zoomed out a little further, but those are the existing pads, Electron launching around here in the middle. And what we can see here is two different timelines. So on the right side of the image, we're gonna have August 30th. And on the left side of the image, we're gonna have August 19th. And I just wanna highlight the changes you're going to see as we go from the 19th over to the 30th. So right now we're on the 19th. Let's drag over and see a more updated image. Okay, so when you first look at it, it may have been a little tough to notice because we are a little more zoomed out, but I want to highlight these distinct patches of brown around this area in the middle here between the current launch pads around where Electron is launching. Very different from just a little over a week ago where it's all green, right? Even up above in this area here, we're seeing all green grass, and then we jump ahead and it's all brown. And I think what we're looking at here, clearly some of the surrounding areas are still green, so it's not that, you know, it's just getting into fall. What we're seeing is the grading of the land, preparing it for paving and construction. So finally, after keeping an eye on this for a while, it does look like work is commencing on this area of Wallops, Virginia. Very exciting. Let's take a quick look at what the launch pad and landing pad is eventually planned to look like. This is the promo picture we have of the Rocket Lab facilities, the eventual launch pad, landing pad setup. And you can see that they do have a pad going out into the water. This whole building, I believe, actually moves, although I do need to refresh myself. We have some fuel tank farms. You know, just kind of a, I'm sure these things change. This was quite a while ago that they released it, but there's clearly a lot of work to be done here. So hopping back over to Planet Labs, we don't really have much in the way of a platform coming out into the water as of yet. Still need to build that, still need to build the pads, the bay for the rockets, and all the rest. So a lot of work to be done, but very exciting to see that this has started. Thanks to Planet Labs for having such a great service. Definitely very valuable having their satellites take images of the Earth so frequently. Okay, so now on to Archimedes. Where are we with that? Well, information is pretty scarce, unfortunately. We can't just have a little camera at their propulsion laboratory. But rounding up some of the news we do have, well, first off, Rocket Lab did contract NASA's Stennis Space Center to be the test facility for the Archimedes engine. So that's definitely a time saver. They don't have to set up their own test facilities. They'll be able to use this extremely robust site for their testing. We also did get some updates on the Archimedes at the last earnings call. I know this is a little bit old, but it's kind of the most recent information we do have. So the thrust chamber development is on schedule for Archimedes. The first full-scale print of Archimedes thrust chamber assembly has been completed using an additive manufacturing customized machine printer. So basically 3D printing that thrust chamber has been completed, an important part of the engine. Injector development testing is also underway, and avionics hardware has been built and hardware in the loop testing is underway. I would say personally, the Archimedes engine is one of the things I'd be worried most for that could potentially delay a late 2024 launch of the Neutron. So it's something we're going to keep an eye out on for more updates as they come out. Now, next up for the upper stage tanks, we're actually going to go all the way back to the other side of the world in New Zealand. Jumping over to an article we have now, interviewing Peter Beck, he did say that they will soon begin qualification tests of these upper stage tanks at their facilities in New Zealand, followed by a destructive test. So qualification test is basically qualifying the design, as far as I'm aware. Again, not a aerospace engineer here, and I don't pretend to be. So anyone in the comments who is more technically knowledgeable, feel free to chime in with more details. But yeah, qualification test, by my understanding, is qualifying the overall design and saying that the design is valid and does work. And then later on, when you get into manufacturing larger numbers of these tanks, you have acceptance testing, meaning that they're testing each individual tank to make sure that it lives up to that design and doesn't have any flaws. And then you also have a destructive test, which is just what it sounds like, basically putting it under more and more stress until it finally is destroyed, just to see where the limits on this tank are, how far you can push it, and under what sort of scenarios it may fail. It's a tricky trade-off here because every pound of weight you add to that upper stage is a pound of payload you're losing. So you want to make it as light as possible, but it still has to be very strong in order to withstand the forces that it's going to be put under. So I'll definitely be excited to see. I don't know if we're going to get any views of some of these tests, but I'm definitely going to be excited to see this tank get frosty. It's going to look kind of like this, like we had previous SpaceX tests on their first stage where they, you know, pump it full of those hypercooled fluids and keep pumping it full until it does explode. I did find it a little bit odd that they're building the test second stage tank out in New Zealand as opposed to Virginia, where we all know that Neutron will be launched, and obviously eventually the whole thing is going to be built out of Virginia, but I guess they just had the facilities and the capacity there, so they figure why not, you know, get testing on the design out in New Zealand. Rocket Lab did also share this cool image of their test stand, ready to hold that second stage as it is pressurized and put through the ringer and then eventually destroyed in a glorious explosion. So this image was shared back in June, and they did say that in the coming weeks, it'll be ready to receive a full-scale second stage tank. So meaning that really this testing should be going on any time now, I would imagine. Once again, when it comes to the first stage tank, information is a bit more scarce. We did get this picture shared by Peter on Twitter a while back showing the first stage test tank in progress, saying love it when a plan comes together and the two sides are obviously coming together. To me, this looks like this is in New Zealand as well. I think just going off the picture, could be wrong on that, but perhaps they're also testing the first stage tanks out there as well. Haven't seen any images yet of the first stage test stand, which would presumably need to be much larger than the second stage test stand. So they would really need to be getting going on that as well to start doing those pressure tests on that first stage tank. And again, in that earnings call, they did share some other updates about these testing plans, saying that upcoming 2023 milestones include that stage one qualification infrastructure to be completed, fuel tanks, fuel farms, all that kind of thing, as well as the structural and cryogenics campaign for stage two. So stage one clearly lagging stage two quite significantly. And I think that stage one is something to keep an eye on as we watch for Neutron's progress in the coming year. So that's all I have for you today on the Neutron updates. Really, the most recent, most exciting thing, in my opinion, is the proof, the pictures that they are working on that Neutron launch pad, which is really required to get the launch off in 2024. Obviously, we don't need to have a landing pad for the first test launch. I feel like there's a good chance they won't be attempting recovery on that one, although you never know. This is really the first time we're watching Rocket Lab develop a vehicle that is reusable from the get-go, as opposed to retroactively changing a vehicle to make it reusable. Their development philosophies may differ from SpaceX in how they go about it. So, in terms of how far along they are, I would say the second stage is looking very promising. That test tank looks ready to go, looks exactly like the picture. They did say a little while back that in the coming weeks they would be starting pressure tests on it. They did share the picture of the test stand, so wouldn't it surprise me if some of those pressure tests have already happened and we haven't seen any footage of it yet, or they're not too far away. Archimedes engine, we still haven't seen any hot fires on that. The test facility is in place. They are working on development of it, and really can't wait for that first test fire of an Archimedes engine. That is going to be so exciting and so important to Neutron's development. And then the first stage tank, I think, is a fair bit further behind, where they're almost ready on pressure testing the second stage. The first stage infrastructure is just getting completed now, so I wouldn't expect pressure testing on that this year. Perhaps next year at some point would be more likely. What do you think is going to be the bottleneck for Neutron's first launch? Is it going to be the launch infrastructure? Is it going to be that first stage tank? Is it going to be Archimedes engine? Are they going to run into problems with that? There are so many things that could change, that could go wrong. Rocket development often has timelines getting extended, things blowing up, unexpected things happening. Let me know down in the comments below what development item you would be the most concerned about. Thank you guys so much for watching. As always, if you haven't already, I hope you'll consider hitting that subscribe button. Every subscriber does really help out, and of course all the likes as well help out with the algorithm. I hope you guys have a great day. I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.